Okay, everyone, so today I'm going to be interviewing ToxicxEternity. They make incredible metal guitar covers of video game themes and have been a YouTuber for as long as I have. So, yeah, man, thank you for taking the time out of your day to be here. So, how are you today?
Hey, man, I'm good. Thank you so much for having me. I'm excited to chat and hang out.
I was a little nervous to approach you at first.
Why? Am I scary?
No. I've just been watching your stuff for a long time, to be honest.
Oh man, well I appreciate that. It's cool. I'm just a nerd who likes to play guitar.
Yeah, I've been on YouTube for like 15 plus years, so I know I ran across your stuff a long time ago too. One of the Edo Castle or from Goemon, Mystical Ninja, yeah.
Oh wow. So like, yeah, that's an old video, dude. That's sick. So you know about that one and everything?
Yeah.
Oh nice. That's cool, man.
I know I did technically just explain it, but it's just for the sake of it. Who are you and what do you do?
Yeah, so my name is Jack. I'm a guitar player, and I do a lot of different things with my guitar. I write original music. Sometimes I'll write music for people, you know, or whatever. But I think the thing that I'm the most known for is my YouTube content, which is making metal guitar versions of video game themes, and that's the ToxicxEternity.
When I was interviewing 8-Bit Drummer, he actually brought up something. You started doing stuff. I think it's on a different YouTube account, right? Because I didn't see it yet, but I know I was recommended a Metal Hellsinger video that you were part of. I think, yeah.
Right. Yeah. Yeah, so what I actually recently started doing about a year ago was putting up reaction videos, checking out video game themes, and like it's something that completely just happened organically because like my Twitch chat just wanted me to do that, so I'm just like, okay, let's do it, and it turns out people were really enjoying it, so I'm like, all right, we'll just make this like a whole YouTube channel then. So it's kind of it feels like the same thing because it's still guitar and it's video game music, you know, but it's just another way of enjoying it, you know.
Mm-hmm. What's the other channel name?
It's just ToxicxEternity TV, like right. Twitch TV, you know.
So where'd you get the idea for your username from?
So the name ToxicxEternity was going to be my band when I was way long ago. It was like around the end of high school. Me and my friend, a couple of my friends actually, we were gonna form a band, and one of the names that we were working on was ToxicxEternity. This was around the same time that YouTube kind of was starting, and the initial idea was that would be like the official YouTube channel for the band, you know.
Yeah.
That ended up, you know, not happening, but, you know, things changed a little bit, but, you know, the name stuck around, so that's just what I go by now.
Do you prefer to, you know, go by the username or just have people call you Jack?
Oh, dude, I'm cool with whatever. I think a lot of people call me Jack, some people call me Toxic. Either Jack or Toxic is, like, pretty normal to me, so.
So, what's your favorite genre of music?
definitely heavy metal is, you know, if you just, that, I know that's a huge, there's so many subgenres and stuff, but really, like, you know, most of the subgenres of metal included in this are under the umbrella of metal. I would say that is, like, my favorite genre, just because that's, like, you know, it's just like what gets me going and what gets me excited about music, you know. Like I certainly listen, it's kind of funny now because I listen to metal, but I listen to so much other music because I want to diversify like my music tastes as much as I can, because I feel like that's good for like writing music is,
yeah, of course.
Having so it's kind of weird how I don't listen to metal as much as I used to because I'm listening to so many other things, but I think metal will always be my favorite music just because of the how meaningful it has been to me and like continues to be, you know.
Yeah. So any favorite like video game OSTs in general?
It's funny because there's some that are like nostalgic to me. So I'll name a couple of like nostalgic OSTs. Mm-hmm. Like certainly like Star Fox is one of my favorite, like for the Nintendo 64, Star Fox 64 is that soundtrack is just super badass. Like I love the boss themes and just like how like creepy a lot of the like area themes are and stuff.
I didn't really think about that to now, but yeah, you're right, a lot of them are kind of creepy.
Yeah, it's cool because it's just like, you know, even when I was a kid, I liked, you know, metal. No, obviously not, I didn't know a lot of metal bands, but like the traditional like big heavy, like Metallica, Megadeth, etc., etc.
Yeah.
And when I heard like Star Fox music, I'm like, this is like the video game version of that. Like it's like it's all it's like badass and like makes you feel like you're on like some evil planet, you know. And I was like, this is cool as hell. So yeah, Star Fox is cool. And then like I'm trying to think of like other N6. I mean, Banjo Kazooie certainly has to be on there for me because
Banjo is like your earliest stuff you did on.
Yeah, YouTube. For sure. It's more. It's like it's an interesting thing of like, did I just like the game so much that the music stuck with me, or did I like the music so the game stuck with me? That's like hard to really know. But the music is just such an integral, like huge part of my, you know, childhood and just growing up with music and stuff.
Yeah.
But then like there's soundtracks that are a little more recent, like certainly like Toby Fox's work with like Undertale and Deltarune was, I think that just hit everybody like a truck, just like with how brilliant and like amazing that music was.
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah, I mean, there's just so many good video game soundtracks that are coming out. I definitely think we're living in a time where video game music is just getting better, you know? Like, it's just more people are able to make it. And, you know, there's just so many great music, like, composers out right now. Like, Danny Baranowski is another one. And, like, with, you know, Crypt of the Necrodancer and stuff like that. I mean, there's just a lot of really great soundtracks out there, but I'll go with like those three, like the Undertale and then like Banjo Kazooie and Star Fox, I think.
Yeah, those are good. And 64 is definitely when stuff started really picking up.
Oh yeah, for sure. Like it's funny because I'll go back and I'll listen to Super Nintendo soundtracks and I'll be like, wow, this is incredible. But when I was a kid, I never owned a Super Nintendo, so I missed out on so many just like amazing games and music from those games. Like obviously like Chrono Trigger, Super Metroid, Link to the Past, you know, freaking like Thunder Force and, you know, just like all these like banger games. But yeah, like, so I definitely think I think like, in my opinion, I feel like Super Nintendo is when it just became like, video game music was awesome, you know.
Yeah, one of my favorite. Like, go on.
Oh, I was just gonna say, because like, I mean, some people might like want to fight me, but I just feel like NES was like people didn't really know what they were doing still, you know. Like,
yeah,
a lot of soundtracks were like bleep bloop blah bleep bloop.
Yeah. With NES, like when I think of NES and music, I think of like Mega Man, Castlevania, and stuff.
Yeah, well, yeah, those games are badass, for sure.
Yeah, at Super NES, I mean, Super Metroid is one of my favorite, like, OSTs.
Mm. Dude, I mean, Super Metroid is one of my favorite games of all time, dude.
Yeah, like, me too.
You know, I didn't grow up with Super Nintendo, but I played that, you know, way later in my life, and I was like, this is a masterpiece.
So what were some of your first experiences with, like, the internet and online in general?
That's a good question. I used to be, like, super into freaking like RuneScape when I was a kid. I played the crap out of that. And I've always been into like online multiplayer games and stuff. Like, so I played a ton of RuneScape. played like Xbox Live. I don't know if that really counts as online internet, like, you know,
basically,
you know, and stuff like that. And you know, I used to enjoy you know, like forums and stuff back in the day, like gaming forums, even mm-hmm. though there's it was a whole different time back then, but it was fun, you know. It was just freaking old school internet, you know. So I just have fond memories of like gaming forums and like Xbox Live and just stuff like that.
I know you've done covers from World of Warcraft, but you mentioned RuneScape. Did you do any? I don't remember.
I never did a whole bunch of RuneScape covers, just because I've never really, like, I'm not particularly huge on RuneScape music. Like, that being said, new RuneScape music, like literally, like, as of like 2 years ago, is phenomenal.
Yeah, RuneScape 3 or whatever, yeah, the most recent.
Yeah. Yeah. But when I hear like Sea Shanty, I'm not necessarily like, oh my god, this is like a masterpiece. You know what I mean?
Yeah, it seems to be the one everyone goes to.
Yeah, like, it's funny. Like, it's a funny song. But it doesn't necessarily like give me emotions or anything, you know.
Yeah. So what was your inspiration to become a guitarist, and how long have you been one?
So my dad is a guitar player. So I grew up in a household that, you know, had a ton of guitars around, and you know, it was kind of just one of those things that was just like, I couldn't escape it, you know, like it was just, there's guitars everywhere, and like my dad would always play guitar, and when I was like a little kid, it was just like, so like, you know, I just thought it was so cool, you know, so I just was like, I want to do that, you know. So it was just kind of one of those things. It was unavoidable. So I just became a guitar player because, you know, my dad played guitar, and, you know, but I obviously went on my own journey with it, like, you know, being more of a metal guy. And so that's pretty much the story of it, you know, just being in a musical household.
Like, how young were you think when you like picked up your first guitar though, to really start?
I think I was pretty young, you know, like I started when I was like a little kid, like maybe 8 years old or something.
Damn.
But, you know, it took me a couple years to really get serious with it. But certainly I was very lucky to discover the instrument like at a young age. So just kind of, I feel like that helped me, you know, learn it.
Yeah.
Just, you know, because they say, I think they say it's just like, if you can discover something at a young age, it's like a little bit easier to learn, you know. So
yeah,
so I think that was just kind of some good luck on my part.
Do you play any other instruments, and if so, what else do you play?
No, I mean, not really. Like, I could, if someone was literally like, you have to play drums right now, like, and I'll, like, I would be like, okay, I could play drums. But I don't really consider myself to be like a drummer or whatever. But I took a year of drum lessons when I was a kid, just to see if I liked it, but I ended up liking guitar more. But I could play like basic drum beats, basically.
So like, outside of music, what are some of your other hobbies?
Just like gaming, dude, you know, like I like to play, I like to play a lot of video games. Just, you know, I'm a huge fan of Blizzard games, like freaking Overwatch, even though I hate that game, but I love it.
Yeah,
you know,
go on.
Yeah, so yeah, I play a lot of games, a lot of online games, because it's like a social thing for me. Like, I like to, that's how I spend time with my friends and stuff.
Yeah.
But let's see. You know, it's really just like, my life is literally music and video games, you know, like,
as long as you're having fun. Yeah.
Yeah. I'm trying to think, like, I feel like I have more hobbies that I'm just not thinking of it right now. I like to drive, you know, sometimes.
Yeah.
I used to have a cooler car, but I'm a one day I'm going to get a nice car again. Cause I like to just drive sometimes.
What kind of car do you want?
Well, see, there's the car that I want. And then there's a car that makes sense to have, you know. But I've driven like some American muscle cars, like, you know, Mustangs and Challengers and Chargers and stuff. Like I drove like a 2008. This is, you know, in 2008. I drove like a 2008 Hemi freaking Charger, and it had like 700 horsepower, and I was like, okay, this is actually kind of sick. Like, you know.
Yeah.
So yeah, like but that's like one of, it's such an expensive hobby though, so I'm just kind of like, I'll wait a little bit for that. But you know, that's something that makes me happy though, is, you know, driving sometimes. But yeah, dude, really, like, besides that, it's, I just like to play games. I like to hang out with my friends and, you know, make music and work, you know.
Yeah, and of course, ever since, you know, online became like a big thing, they made it easier to, you know, at least be able to play with your friends. Like, I've always preferred to play in person, but, you know, as the years go on, it's harder for that. So, yeah, what we have now is good.
Yeah, absolutely. You know, especially with just, like, with the way the last couple of years have been, just with the pandemic and stuff, it's kind of just, like, I feel like, you know, we just, nobody did anything for 2 years. So I feel like we're all just, like, what should I do now that I can kind of do things again, you know?
Yeah.
But that's a cool, it's a good thing though, you know, we're just figuring out stuff to do. So I'll, maybe a year from now, you know, I'll get back to you and tell you what I'm doing.
So what would you say are some of the, like, highlights of your career as a guitarist so far?
Oh man, I've had some really cool experiences. I've done some crazy stuff, man. Like I certainly think one really cool time in my life was, I think it was like 2018. I got flown out to Germany to work with an amplifier company called Hughes & Kettner, that they make the amplifier that I use. And they wanted to fly me out to like do content with them. So that was like a big deal to me, because I'm like, I've never left the country before that. So it was just a way to not only see the world and see a different country, but also to like get flown out because of guitar playing. That felt super cool to me, you know?
Yeah.
So that was pretty badass. And then, like, in Germany, we did some crazy stuff. Like we did this thing called Rockin' 1000, which is something that they do in Europe, and I think they might do it in the States soon, but I think at the time it was only Europe. And it was like, it's like a concert with the band consists of like 1,000 people, so it's like 100 guitar players or whatever. And it was like in an arena, and there was, the audience consisted of like about 20,000 people.
Damn.
So it was just like this obnoxiously huge concert. So I got to be a part of that. I mean, literally, you know, 6 months ago, I got to go on stage with Dragon Force, and I got to hang out with Herman Lee. That was really cool. You know, before that, I got to meet Dream Theater, got to go backstage. You know, dude, it's just, there's a lot of really crazy moments that happen like that, you know. I've had dinner with like some really famous rock star dudes, you know. Like, so sometimes you just find yourself in those situations, you're like, whoa, this is crazy, you know.
Yeah, you definitely seem like you're having a lot of fun, so that's good,
dude. It's fun, and but it's also kind of just like, what is going on? It's very like
mind blowing.
You're like, how did this happen? You know?
Yeah, you probably definitely didn't expect that. You know, that would be a thing that you were going to like actually have happen to you. Just the things you've mentioned so far.
Yeah, because like to me, dude, it's like truly the 100% truth of it is that I consider myself to just be like. I'm just like a normal guy, you know what I mean? Like, I just play video games. I like to play guitar. I like to make music, you know. But it's not like back in the day when it was like, oh, I'm a rock star, and I here's my limo and my autographs, you know. And like, and I think people kind of like, when you're a rock star from back in the day, you kind of like assume that identity, and you're like, this is who I am. I'm, you know. And for me, I'm just kind of sitting here like in my pajamas playing, you know, playing online whatever games with my homies and just being, you know, and then then I get an email from like, you know, hey, we want you to do this crazy rock star thing, and I'm like, what the hell, you know?
Yeah, times change.
Yeah, it's cool though, you know. I feel like that's good for me because it makes me not like, you know, I mean, it's not like it keeps my ego in check. It keeps everything like cool, you know. But it definitely sometimes is like, whoa,
yeah,
I'm doing some crazy stuff, you know.
Yeah, I understand.
So it's cool. It's a roller coaster.
So, what's the best piece of advice another musician's ever given you?
That's such a good question.
If you gotta think about
it, I would say like it's not really there. The one that came to my head is, and it's not, it doesn't apply only to music. It's kind of like a life thing, but certainly it helps with music as well. And that's just like, if it ain't broke, don't fix it. Like, because that kind of applies to like, in a musical sense, that applies to, you know, if I'm working on music and I'm sitting here just being like, oh man, I want to try all this crazy stuff, and sometimes I'll try crazy stuff and it'll work. But a lot of times I've made the mistake of trying crazy stuff just because I feel like I have to try crazy stuff, and then it'll make it worse. So kind of the thing that I'll tell myself sometimes, I'm like, hey dude, if people are enjoying it the way it is, you know, like just give people what they enjoy, and you know, if it ain't broke, don't fix it, you know.
Yeah,
that kind of a thing. So that certainly is something that you know, applies. And like, if you want to get like really technical, it's kind of just like, you know, in terms of buying like guitars and buying amplifiers, like sometimes musicians or, you know, music producers will be like, oh, I need this new, you know, mixer XL5000 that just came out, because, you know, X, Y, and Z. And it, that philosophy of the infinite broke, don't fix it, kind of helps me not go broke, because you don't always need the latest and greatest technology if you can make it work with what you have, you know?
Yeah, sometimes the stuff you have, you're like, yourself is just really good, and yeah, you don't have to just overextend yourself.
Yeah. Yeah. Exactly. And also it's like, you know how to use the stuff that you already do, you know.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I'm definitely a believer in like, you should be a specialist, you know, in what, like, whether it's visual art, whether it's music. I think, and this is just my opinion, I'm not like saying if you disagree then you're wrong or whatever, but I think being a specialist is cool, like just focusing on like one thing, like, you know, because there's definitely times where like someone will hit me up to do like music that's not with guitars and metal music, and I'll be like, this is cool, but like, are you sure that you want me for that? Because I'm like the guitar guy, you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
I think it's cool to have like a thing that you do, you know.
Mm-hmm.
So that's, it just simplifies things for me. And I'm just kind of like, okay, this is what I do. This is what I need to do it. And then if it's that simple, then you can just focus on actually putting out, you know, content instead of worrying about what you do and what you need and everything like that.
Yeah. So like, what goals do you hope to achieve like in the future as a guitarist?
I would certainly love to make music for a video game. There's definitely a lot of things that are like in the works, and you know, the gaming industry is definitely a roller coaster, so there's a lot of seeds that are planted, and I feel really good about that goal happening. But I really just want to do a soundtrack for a banger freaking video game. I think that would be really fun. And I know it's funny because it kind of contradicts literally everything I was just saying, but I want to do a soundtrack where there's actually not guitar in it. And I know that literally contradicts everything I just said, but I just want to do that because it would be fun, like, and I just want to challenge myself, you know. But the difference is, the reason it's not contradicting myself is because I am going to be the one who, like, decides what I want to do, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
So, but if it's like, if it was someone like wanted to commission me and like wanted to like tell me what to do, I'd be like, okay, but it has to be guitar, you know.
Like, what if Toby Fox came over, like, hey, you want to help with something?
Yeah, well, dude, certainly. Like, I mean, there's always an exception to the rules, right? Dude, if Toby Fox hit me up, I'll do anything, you know?
Yeah.
So, yeah, I would love to do just a soundtrack. And then I just want to, like, play more shows in different countries. Like, I would love to go to, you know, I've never been to Japan before, but I would love to go to Japan. I would love to see more of Europe. You know, I just want to play music in as many places as possible, you know?
Yeah.
So that's, you know, hopefully we could do something like that at some point.
Yeah, extend your reach, have, you know, more people hear your music, you know, like, just be happy overall with it.
Yeah, absolutely. But it's kind of just, it's kind of just basically doing what I'm already doing and just having it continue to grow.
Yeah. So how well do you manage with improvisation?
I mean, I consider myself to be pretty good at it. Like, it's something that I practice a lot. And that's a big part of, like, what my my Twitch stream is like.
Yeah.
Because on a lot of these videos where I'm reacting to a video game song, like, it'll be a song that I haven't heard before. So that certainly will put my improvisation abilities to the test. And I'll have to come up with something right then and there that will work for the song. So I'd consider myself to be pretty good at it. Certainly not. There's loads of musicians who are better than me. There's always a bigger fish, but I think I'm pretty good at it. It's one of my stronger things.
Yeah, going off of that, has there ever been like a song that you've tried to do a cover of and it's just been like, I don't want to say too hard, but like, what's the hardest thing you tried to cover, really?
There's been a couple of things that I tried and I just decided it doesn't work. You know, an example, and I don't really, well, you know what? I don't want to give examples because I don't want to like bum people out. They'll be like, oh man, you should have done that, you know?
Yeah, I understand.
But like, There's a couple of soundtracks that I'm just like, yeah, this should stay as it is. You know what I mean? Like this, yeah. Like metal. It's a 99.9% success rate, but there's that 0.1% where you're like, you know what, not feeling that. You know.
Yeah, I understand. You don't want to answer because yeah, what you said, people will hear. If anyone hears that, it's like, oh no, you should do that.
Yeah. That doesn't bum me out too much though, because I'm like, dude, it, like 99.9% of stuff slaps as metal covers, so it is what it is, you know.
Mm-hmm. So if you have any, what's your process for dealing with performance anxiety?
It's really the something that I do that I tell myself when I'm about to go on stage, because I do get nervous, you know. Is I'm like, dude, we're all just here to have fun, you know. Like, no, like the people in the audience don't want to see you mess up. Like, they just want to enjoy themselves. They paid money. They just want to have a fun time. So it's like, it's really, you know, if you miss a note or if you like trip and fall, it's just like, it's fine. We're all just here to like have a good time, you know?
Yeah.
So I know it sounds like so simple, but I think when you're a performer, sometimes you feel like the audience is there to judge you and they're not, like, they're, you know, half of them are probably drunk, you know, like the other half are just like, they don't know about what kind of strings you're using, or they don't know the music theory behind, you know, they're just there to like have a fun time. Right. So
yeah, honestly,
I just think it's easy to forget that. But once I like digest that, I'm like, oh yeah, let's just like, we're just having fun, you know?
Yeah, you make a good point because, you know, thinking about when I've been to concerts, yeah, I don't go there to judge. I just go there to have a fun time and listen to music.
Yeah, you know, and it's definitely like, it's really easy to fall into that mindset of like, oh, like, everyone's going to laugh at me if I mess up, or everyone's going to think I suck or whatever. And it's like, no, like, just get out there and have fun, you know, just
yeah.
That's all it is.
What's one of the best concerts you've been to and why?
I would say like a really impactful concert when I was younger was like, I saw this band, Children of Bodom, who's like a really great metal band. And, you know, they were incredible, and it just had a huge impact on me. They just write like super intense, like shred guitar, but they have a keyboard player and he like shreds with them. You know, and it was just like, whoa, you know, because I was like 16, you know, I was like, this is the coolest thing I've ever seen in my life. So that was very impactful for me. And then, of course, you know, dude, you know, I saw Metallica when I was a kid, and that was like, their stage show is nuts, you know, like their whole stage at some point like blows up and it looks like the arena is like gonna collapse, and you realize it's just part of the show, and you're like, whoa, that's cool.
Yeah, I'm jealous. I wish I could have seen Metallica.
Oh, dude, yeah, well, it looks like they're freaking doing it, so who knows, maybe they'll come around. But yeah, so I've seen a lot of really great concerts, but those two kind of stuck out for me.
Who are some of your other like favorite metal guitarists?
Funny enough, I just mentioned Children of Bodom, but the guitar player for that who just recently passed away, so RIP, but the dude Alexei from Children of Bodom was a huge influence for me. You know, again, I brought up Metallica as well, but like, you know, James Hetfield and Kirk Hammett, you know, were huge influences. Angus Young from AC/DC was a huge influence. John Petrucci from Dream Theater, certainly another big influence. I think those guys are like, oh, and Michael Romeo for sure. I literally steal so many of his licks, it's gross, but his style is just like amazing. So I love Michael Romeo from Symphony X. Yeah, I think that's a good. That's most of them.
This might be silly, but so has anyone ever said like thank you for covering some of the lesser covered songs from games? Because you've covered a lot of stuff I've seen that like not many other people do.
Yeah, dude. You know, for me, it's just like, I mean, yeah, people say that a lot, and that makes me feel really good. You know, and a lot of that is because I actually take requests from my Patreon supporters. Well, I used to. I had to stop because I literally got so many requests that it was like a 2-year waiting list. Yeah. So I'm like, okay.
Yeah, it definitely gets to a point where you kind of just gotta draw the line and be like, okay, we need to stop for now. Or just stop.
Yeah. So yeah. But I used to do that. I used to take requests, and a lot of those songs were requested from my Patreon supporters. So it's cool that people say thank you to me for doing that, but I consider it kind of a team effort, because it was like a lot of people were like, dude, you got to cover this song. And I'm like, and I'll be like, I've never heard of this song. And then I'll hear it and I'll be like, oh, damn. Yeah, we need to cover this, you know? So, yeah, it's something I'm happy to do that, you know? So it's really cool. And yeah, it was kind of a team effort, you know? So now it's like, now that I'm not doing Patreon requests anymore, we're doing actually a thing where it's like a voting system. So it's I think it'll still have the similar results of doing some themes, that it's not just like the most popular theme from the most popular game and then that's it. You know, there's a lot of amazing video game songs out there that aren't just like the main theme or whatever, you know, the final boss theme, you know?
Yeah, like I mentioned Edo Castle and whatnot. Like, you've covered a few things from Mystical Ninja Star and Goemon, and that I haven't heard as many people cover. Also, you did Dark Cloud's main theme. You did another medium from Undertale back. But, like, not a lot of people did that one specifically, I noticed. Mm.
That's like the best Undertale song, dude. Yeah. Like, straight up, I love that theme.
Yeah, I have a list. I mean, if I went over the entire list of things, because I was like, I should write down some of their covers that they did that I like. But then I realized, I'm like, okay, this is now a giant list. But yeah, no, you've definitely done a lot that I'm not used to hearing other people doing as much. And I also didn't realize until today when I was looking through your stuff again, but I was like, oh yeah, they did Cradle. I'm like, oh wait, that was with 8-Bit Drummer. I'm like, oh shit.
Yeah, dude. But yeah, no, Cradle is freaking is super sick. You know, that was such a fun song to do with Jared. So
yeah, I know you did. You also did Runaway. Runaway. That's what it was. So it was Boss Battle 2 from Legend of Dragoon. Do you remember if that one was a Patreon request?
Yes. Yeah, that was a Patreon request. You know, like so. A lot of them are Patreon requests. You know, so I can't take all the credit, you know, that it's a team effort.
Well, it's a team effort, but you still did it at least. And like, I feel like Legend of Dragoon doesn't get as much love as it should.
Dude, those boss themes are so killer. Yeah. Like, yeah, all three of them, right? I think there's three. They're all so uniquely badass.
Yeah, there's three, and then the final boss theme, I think. And including the Virage theme, which I'm pretty sure is a unique one, too. And also, I'll go over one more, but yeah, your Miracle Matter one you did with Jules a long time ago, I think, that was really good.
Oh, hell yeah. That's a banger.
I was playing, doing a playthrough of Kirby 64 on stream, I think like a year ago, and when I got to Miracle Matter, I was like, okay, hold on, I paused it, and I put on your cover, it made it more epic.
Oh, thank you.
But yeah, I really like that. Okay, all right, so out of all the covers you've done, do you have, like, a personal favorite or a few personal favorites that you've done?
I'm actually really proud of my Time Scar cover, because, like, that was, like, a recent one, but that's one of my favorite video game themes ever, so that was super fun. I really wanted to nail that one, and I feel like I did. I feel like my covers in the last year are some of my best ones. Which is a good feeling, you know.
Of course, you've been improving.
I feel like I'm just like narcissistically going through my own videos right now and just trying to find. I really like Mega Man 04, my straight ahead cover, because I just really like that theme. That's such a badass Mega Man theme.
I think you did two from 04. It was Falling Down in that one.
Oh yeah, dude. That's another banger, too. Mega Man Zero is... so many of those themes are phenomenal.
Yeah, you definitely are improving, but, like, your old work's still, like, very good, too.
Well, thank you. Yeah, I mean, like, I'm proud of all my stuff, right? Because it's always, like... certainly my like, quality of, like, you know, like, the tones and, like, that's improving. But, like, I'm always proud of my arrangements, though. Like, I think some of my old-school arrangements are, like, super... clever and stuff, and I'm like, oh, that was like, I'll like forget how one of my songs goes, and I'll be like, oh, that's cool how I did that or whatever. So I'm proud of all my work, you know, but I just, it's a good feeling to feel like you're putting out some of your best stuff, you know, now. You know,
yeah, now I feel bad for saying good things about old stuff too.
Oh dude, no, you're good.
I was gonna say, because one of the ones you did also, like, back then, that was still one of my favorites, is the wing cap theme from Mario 64.
Oh, yeah. Well, I also feel like, most musicians like their new stuff the most, but I think with fans and listeners, they have, like, an emotional connection to, like, a song that they've heard for a while. So I think that's, like, that's normal, right? And certainly if, like you mentioned Wing Cap, like, that's cool as hell, because I'm still super proud of that theme, you know? And, like, I can listen to it and be like, oh, like, the kick drum is too loud. Or just, like, something really random that no one cares, you know? Yeah. But, like, when anybody else listens to that, they don't hear it the way that I hear it. They hear it as, like, a complete song, and they probably hear it as being perfect. And that's amazing to me, you know?
Yeah, I mean, as content creators and also, you know, musicians and whatnot, like, we usually are our own worst, like, our most severe critic.
Yeah. but I'm also able to like take a step back and be like, no one cares about what the kick drum, you know what I mean? They want to hear Wing Cap as a metal song, you know, and I certainly pulled that off, you know.
Well, talking about old to new, I mean, you recently redid WizPig, which was ancient for you.
Yeah, well, that, like, I'll just say that straight up. Like, the original one that I did of that was, the sound quality was so bad. Because I was, like, literally, that was one of my first videos I ever did. So, yeah. I'm like, dude, WizPig is such a banger, and we need to give this the treatment that it deserves.
Yeah, I agree. I love and hate WizPig.
Yeah, no, that boss fight is so freaking hard, dude. Yeah. But that was fun. I actually really like remaking some of my older covers, because it's just a direct here's the improvement that I've done, you know.
Yeah, I don't think, unless I'm wrong, I don't think you've ever redid the Mad Monster Mansion one, did you?
No, and that's weird, right? I should do that.
It would make sense.
Yeah, I totally should. I almost like, I think I just want to wait until I'm like even better, you know.
Yeah,
but that's kind of funny, because it's like, how do you know, you know? But I'll do that eventually, for sure.
So who are some of your other just like favorite content creators on YouTube and etc.?
Oh, who are some of my favorite content creators? Because I have like my friends.
Technically, they count.
Yeah, like, I mean, I'm very inspired by my friends, you know. I certainly Family Jewels is like my boy. Mm-hmm. And we go back, and I think we both kind of feed each other, you know what I mean?
Yeah,
because we both kind of just kind of like feed each other inspiration, and we'll always be showing each other what we're working on and just be like, bro, that's insane. So Jules, certainly, like Jared, dude, like 8-bit drummer, is,
yeah,
not only is he like the homie, but he's like his work ethic and his like the way he just his community, the way he talks to his community, is just like, I'm sitting there with my notepad, just like, you know, like I'm in college, just like taking notes, because he's just got it dialed, you know.
He's also extremely energetic.
Well, yeah, for sure. That I'm like, I will, like, that's like, I'm like, unless I have a coffee just like injected into my veins, I'm like, bro, like Jared is the king of energy.
Yeah.
But that's great, and that's what he does, you know. So like, who else? I mean, certainly, dude, just like Jared and Jules are the goats for me. But there's so many people, dude, you know, like,
yeah, there's a lot of people nowadays.
I mean, there's people that don't even play music, you know what I mean? Like, there's people who play video games, and
yeah,
you know, like my homie Jacob, Alpha Rad, you know, he's like, he's amazing, and he's just built this amazing world around him, you know, like he's got like all this content that he does, and it's, yeah, very inspiring to see all that.
Yeah, he's funny.
My homie 66 Samus, who's a drummer, he's awesome too. He's literally like, he's like a death metal version of Jared.
Oh boy.
So he's cool. And there's so many, but you know, I think I'll leave it at that. But those are the homies for sure.
I'm just gonna throw one person out there just to ask if you heard of them. You ever see any of Little V's covers?
Oh dude, yeah, Little V's another homie, yeah. He is certainly up there, like with Jules and Jared, just in terms of like I, what Little V does, that's so amazing to me. First of all, his voice is, I had no idea he could belt it out like that until he started doing it more.
Yeah, he's good.
And I was like, oh my god, like, you're an incredible singer alongside being a guitar player, you know. Mm-hmm. And but also like his just like his production quality, like just the sound quality of what he does, I'm like, it's like kind of mind-blowing, honestly. So that's cool. And then if we're just talking about like the boys, right, like the you know, you got to put in Johnny Atma too, right?
He's been around, like, for a long time.
Yeah, like that dude shreds on guitar. It's nutty. like when we were doing like Spark Mandrill, we did a cover of that together, and he sent me his solos, and I was like, oh god, like we got, because we were like doing a solo battle, you know, and yeah. I was like, oh my god, I gotta step it up, dude. You know, his shredding, like his just actual guitar abilities is like nutty, so he's really good.
Yeah, you're reminding me that I need to go back and start listening, looking into people's stuff again, because it's been a while since I've heard some of the, like Johnny Amma, I haven't heard some of his stuff in a while, but I know he's been around forever, and I've always been a, you know, a fan of him.
Yeah, and then Rich also. Rich is the homie.
Oh yeah, of course. Jesus.
Yeah, I know. It's like they just keep popping up. You're like, I know I'm forgetting something. Like, Rich is the homie for sure.
Weren't you in his video for Bone Truzzle, I think?
Yep. Yeah, that was way back in the day. Yeah, we've done a lot of stuff together. We've done some Sonic songs. We've done Pokemon. You know, we did Deltarune. He's always a blast to work with.
Yeah, he seems like it for sure. So do you have any advice for, you know, someone wanting to become a guitarist in like 2022 based on your past experiences?
Someone wanting to become a guitarist. Well, I will say that guitar is one of the, I would consider guitar to be one of the easiest instruments to learn, which is great because, you know, like you can just kind of get right into having fun, right? So congratulations, you chose an instrument that is pretty easy to learn. That doesn't mean that it's not going to be for us. I mean, it depends, like it has a high skill ceiling, of course.
Yeah.
You know, but like, you know, if you just want to get into playing some riffs and stuff, you just put it in drop D and then you literally just like flatten your finger on it and then you're good. You know, so yeah, that's great. Just like, I mean, really it's all about having fun, dude. You know, I think people get way too crazy about like practicing, which certainly practicing is good to do, but if you're just like having fun, you're also getting better, you know. So it's just like just have fun, like, and I know that sounds like such a generic thing, but people literally forget that, you know. So it's, yeah, just have fun with it and like just don't let it bum you out, you know.
Yeah,
and there's always going to be someone that's better than you, so just like don't let that discourage you.
Yeah, don't just constantly compare yourself to others, and also don't, shit, I forgot where I was going with that, but yeah, no, if you're not having fun with what you're doing, then, like, you know, at that point, you really need to start rethinking some stuff.
Yeah, and also don't go broke, because, like, guitars, like, it's so expensive,
like,
because there's so many little gadgets and pedals and amps, and it's just, like, literally, you could buy, like, spend money on a good guitar, but that's it, like, you know, you don't need to spend money on a good amp because you could literally buy like plugins for your computer. You don't need pedals. You don't, you know, just like, just buy a guitar that feels amazing to play in your hands and then like you're good.
What was the first video game you ever played or experienced?
I think it was, I mean, like for like actual video games, because I've played like arcade, like, I've been to like the dentist and they have like Frogger or whatever. But, like, you know, I think, like, Mario Kart 64 was, like, when that first came out, that was at my friend's house, and that was, like, the first, like, legitimate console video game that I've played, and that was sick, you know, and literally, like, I was, like, pretty much begging my parents to buy me an N64 from that moment until they finally did, so...
Yeah, N64 is really just such a good system to play with four people, especially when just Smash came out.
Oh yeah, dude, Smash was so sick, and like, I mean, I don't know, it's hard to really describe that, because I feel I'm gonna sound like such a freaking old man right now, but it's hard to describe how crazy that was looking at like Super Mario 64 for the first time.
I understand.
And you're like, whoa, it's in 3D, bro. This is crazy. You know, and like Ocarina of Time, dude, like that was nuts, you know? So that was just, people talk crap about the N64 because it does look terrible now, but that was a huge leap in like gaming, you know?
Yeah, I have a lot of good memories of stuff. And going off of one of the things you just said, I have a memory of, like, being smaller, walking into a Best Buy, and there was a really big TV in the distance where, like, the video games and stuff were, and it had people playing Mario 64 on it. And my, like, little brain, like, exploded just seeing it. It was just like, wow.
Yeah. And it's funny how when you're a kid, it's like, it looks like such a... Because I've seen, like, Mario 64 speedruns and stuff where they just, like, they'll just, like, jump up, like, a rock and then just, like, get the star instantly. But when you're a kid, you go to like, the first level and you're just like, this is freaking huge, bro. I'm scared. Like, it's like a whole world, dude.
Yeah, speedruns are a whole different monster. Those are really... like impressive. Like I could do some games, but not Mario 64. That shit's really hard to do in speedrunning.
Yeah, that's crazy. That's actually, like, you were talking about hobbies and stuff. I like to watch like speedruns and stuff. Like AGDQ and SGDQ are like some of my favorite times of the year, just watching all that stuff.
Yeah, GDQ's been around for a long time. It started off in just the basement of somebody and went to where it is now. I'm really happy with the, you know, progress that GDQ's made.
Yeah. I mean it's literally like this huge thing now.
Did you ever attend one or no?
No, I've never been to one. I've like kind of wanted to go. Like I might one day. I want to bring like some homies though, you know. Mm-hmm. Like, but I think that'd be fun for sure. I'd like to be a part of that.
So, what are some of your favorite video games of all time? Like, do you have any that are just unbeatable to you? Like when I say unbeatable, just like in terms of how good they are.
I'm a huge Metroid fan, so, like, I would say my favorite game of all time is Metroid Prime. Mm-hmm. And maybe Metroid Prime 2 is, like, I like that more, but it's more just, like, aesthetics compared, but, like, you know, the playing, like, the nostalgia of Metroid Prime 1 is, like, insane to me. So I love those games. And you know, I'm a huge WoW nerd. Like I've been playing Warcraft for forever. So I love that's like something that's gotten me through a lot of tough times. Whenever I'm going through some shit in my life, I just jump into Azeroth and like fucking lose it, you know, and just like forget everything about myself, which is really nice sometimes.
I gotta ask, as someone who's played since vanilla, which expansion do you think was your like favorite to experience?
That is such a good question. I mean, I'm literally playing Wrath of the Lich King right now.
Yeah,
classic. Like so that, and I'm like, wow, this is really fun. You know,
did you get to experience it when it happened?
I did, but I was like a little baby, and I was so bad at the game.
Yeah, Wrath is really like where I got into it, so it's like really special to me.
Yeah, like I'm cracked at it now, right? So I'm going through and I'm being like, wow, I used to think this was hard. I'm like freaking speed running this now, you know?
Yeah.
So that's enjoyable. And like, so Wrath was cool. I thought Legion was a really cool expansion because I liked being a demon hunter. That was badass.
Yeah, Legion was really fun.
You know, and then they obviously, you know, being a WoW fan is hard because they have some questionable expansions. like Shadowlands was not, that was so hard to enjoy that.
Yeah, I understand. But, I've been around with Blizzard for a long, long time. I mean, I initially started off as like a Diablo guy and then eventually got into World of Warcraft, etc.
Yeah, Diablo 2 is like one of the best games ever made, yep, for sure. Overwatch was, I really like Overwatch. I mean, like I'm definitely not good at it, like, but I like to, you know, I'm one of the people who actually root for Overwatch. I'm like, I want that game to succeed. People are just like, Overwatch League is just so dumb, and I'm like, yeah, but that'd be cool if it worked, you know. Yeah, like, so it's I like Overwatch. So let's talk about like so other games, like more, yeah, regular games. Like I like Zelda games a lot. Like I'm a big Nintendo fan, so like, you know, Ocarina of Time, Majora's Mask. I really liked Breath of the Wild a lot. I'm actually freaking stoked for Tears of the Kingdom. That's gonna be so good.
Yeah, it comes out early next year, right?
Is it that? I thought it was like later, but I could be.
I might be wrong too. I
remember it being like a while from now.
Yeah, no, so I might be wrong because I know it was supposed to come out this year, got delayed, and yeah, I'm looking forward to it.
Yeah. Also, Pokemon, dude. Like, I love Pokemon.
Scarlet.
I'm excited. Violet. Yeah, dude. I'm excited for Scarlet and Violet. I just Pokemon's cool, but I just feel like I don't know. I just. It's the same thing as being a Blizzard fan, where you're like, I love this IP, but sometimes these people just drop the ball so hard, you know?
Yeah, sadly that happens with, you know, a lot of companies and games and whatnot.
Yeah, but the IP itself and, like, 90% of the design choices are good. You know, they do good enough of a job that I love it, so, you know.
Yeah, I have a love-hate relationship with Pokemon, but I still, find a lot of enjoyment with it.
So. It's great. I mean, it's like, that's the thing when you're a fan of video games, like, the ones that you love the most are also the ones that you criticize the most, you know?
Mm-hmm.
So it's kind of like, it's like I can sit here and be like, Pokemon is like, they're just, these games are so trash, but then I'm just sitting here, like, playing all of them and, like, being like, okay, maybe I just like these games, you know?
Yeah.
So, that's funny. Being a video game fan is, it's something else.
It's tug of war. On the opposite side of things, like, what are some of your, like, least favorite? Just things you don't enjoy overall.
Well, it's mostly just games that I'm not good at, right? Like, I don't like games that I'm not good at. And I'm also lazy, so I don't want to, like, work towards being good. I just want to be naturally good.
Lazy doesn't usually mix well with Dark Souls.
Yeah, dude. Well, Dark Souls is like, dude, I've tried a lot of Dark Souls, and I can see why people like it, but like, I just haven't completely freaking gotten in there, whatever that means. Like, I haven't, like, discovered the love of the Souls games.
It just hasn't clicked with you yet.
Yeah, because everyone's like, dude, you gotta play Bloodborne, because, like, you're a metalhead. And I'm just like, that's cool. Like, I've seen Bloodborne, and I've played a little bit, and I'm like, this is badass, you know? Like, and I'll keep trying it, you know? I'll keep chugging along, but it hasn't captivated me as much as other games have. But and then I will say, just a whole genre in general that is kind of hard for me is like super intense, like JRPG kind of stuff, where there's like a ton of menuing and customization and stuff. Just because my caveman brain can't handle that.
I partially had a feeling you were going to say that, because up to this point, I don't think you really mentioned RPGs too much.
Well, yeah.
Outside of Chrono Trigger.
Yeah, I mean, like, even Pokemon sometimes, I'm like, oh, I gotta put all this, like, held items, and like, what is this, you know? And, like, because I tried to play, like, Xenoblade, and I'm like, okay, this is sick, but my brain literally can't comprehend this, like, you know?
Yeah.
But that, like, that's not, like, I'm not saying the games are bad, like, you know, I'm just, everyone has their, what they like, you know,
yeah,
like, for me, I'm definite, I like to shut my brain off when I play games, you know,
mm-hmm.
So it's kind of like, that's, you know, some people like to turn their brain on, you know, I like to shut it off a lot of times, so that's just what it is.
Do you have a favorite genre?
I don't know. I mean, I like RPGs as long as they're not, like, super crazy. That's why I said like JRPGs, because I feel like those are a little bit more crazy.
Mm-hmm.
Like, but I like a little bit more simple RPGs, you know, like Final Fantasy is cool and like stuff like that, which I guess that's technically still a JRPG, but it's not like as crazy as like Xenoblade and stuff like that.
Yeah, no, I understand that. I'm a little iffy with Xenoblade. Like, I like it, but there's also part of it that still hasn't clicked with me. I'm actually playing Chronicles 3 now, and it hasn't clicked entirely with me, so I understand what you're saying.
Yeah, like, there's no doubt in my mind that those are amazing games, and, like, when people say they love them, I'm like, I bet you do, you know, like, I'm sure they're great, you know, so everyone just has what they like and what they don't like, you know?
Mm-hmm. What's your favorite franchise?
Certainly, Metroid, yeah, for sure.
How about, like, your favorite video game console or handheld?
I actually really like the Switch. I think the Switch is a really good that ended up being a great thing, you know? Like, I mean, it still holds up. It's been out for what, like 5 years or something?
Yeah.
Like, it's still chugging along, you know? Because it's just like, I don't really care about like graphics and stuff, you know?
Yeah.
As long as it has like a smooth feel to it and has like a cool art style. So I think the Switch is cool. I like being able to take it portable, and you know, I feel like Nintendo did pretty good with that. I think Nintendo, I didn't like the Wii and the Wii U that much because I'm not a big motion control guy. But I thought the GameCube was solid. I thought the N64 was kind of weird because the controller is kind of weird. But I think the GameCube and the Switch are like solid consoles, you know?
Yeah. So when you said the N64 controller thing, the only thing that came to my mind was Mario Party 1. Because, you know, they're like destroyed hands.
Oh, yeah, where you had to like move the control stick around.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
I was affected by it.
Oh, yeah. No, dude, that controller is not good at all. It's very bad.
Yeah. Have you ever had an experience while playing a video game that's just like really stuck out to you? You'll always remember?
I really enjoyed playing Breath of the Wild. Like, I thought, I just remember like seeing some of those. I'm not gonna like say it too much, but like I remember just some of those experiences with the large creatures.
Yeah, I know what you mean.
Like I'm just like, what? That's crazy. You know, when you see those for the first time, you're like, whoa, that's nutty. You know.
Yeah, Breath of the Wild was definitely an experience. It was fun. It was a lot of fun.
Yeah. That's like, that was, to me, that was just like, that was exactly what I want in a video game. I just truly was like blown away. Not by like how good it is, but just how much it has what I want. You know, I'm like, oh, yeah. I wish I could do this. Oh, I can, you know?
Yeah. I completely understand what you're saying. I ended up liking it a lot more than I thought it would. Like, I knew I was going to like it, but just the more I played it, I didn't really want to stop, and there was just so much to see and do.
Yeah, there's certainly flaws with it. Like, I really hope that the Tears of the Kingdom, I hope the dungeons are a little more unique from each other.
Yes.
And I think that's pretty much everyone's kind of on that page with it.
Yeah.
But, like, that, you know, there's that and, like, maybe something, maybe the durability could be less frustrating. But besides that, I mean, I thought it was so solid.
Yeah, if it had more traditional just dungeons, they're like, I don't know, they were underground or something, like old Zelda dungeons, I would be happy.
Yeah.
Has any video game ever made you emotional? If so, what was it and why?
I mean, dude, like, when you do the pacifist run on Undertale, you know, it's like, especially after doing the neutral run before that, you're like, whoa, this is, like, you feel like that game makes you feel like such an asshole. Like, you know? Like,
yeah, Toby's good at writing. You're
like, I can't believe I killed these guys. What the hell, dude?
Yeah, yeah, Toby's very good at world building.
Yeah, he's also good at just making you feel like the worst person. Like, just like such an awful, but it's like in a good way, you know?
Yeah.
So, yeah. And then, emotional, you know? It's just like, I mean, certain, again, dude, Breath of the Wild, man. Like, some of those. So sometimes you like walk on a cliff and you see the sunset and you're like, whoa, this is, you know.
Yeah, I've had those moments.
Yeah, so I mean, like, dude, when you first walk out in Breath of the Wild and you see the whole world, you're like, how can you not be emotional when you see that? You're like, this is insanity. That's, you know, I don't, like, I'm sure if I played more JRPGs and if I played more story based games, I'm sure I would have more things like that, but I tend to play games that are kind of like exploration kind of things, so yeah. There's not a whole lot of like gut-wrenching moments in those besides just the emotion of like what you see and your own experiences, you know.
Yeah, just like exploring something and just finding a discovery that's like really cool.
Yeah, just having your own kind of like moments with it.
So yeah, favorite kind of cheese?
Pepper jack for sure.
You're the first one to say that one.
Yeah, that's good.
Favorite food?
Pizza.
I agree with pizza being good. There was a point in my life for some reason that I hated pizza. I don't know why. I don't hate it anymore, but it was there.
Mm.
Well, okay, you know what? What's your favorite topping on pizza then?
Pepperoni.
Okay, good.
I'm a basic bitch. I'm sorry.
At least it's not pineapple.
Oh, yeah, no. I mean, I actually don't mind it, but it wouldn't be my first choice.
Yeah, favorite flavor of ice cream.
That's actually hard. Depends on what mood I'm in. Like, I like strawberry most of the time, but sometimes I'll see, like, you know, cookies and cream, and I'll be like, damn, okay.
Yeah, strawberry is one of my favorite.
Strawberry is good, yeah.
Hot or cold weather?
Hot, usually. I mean, that's just, like, where I grew up. I grew up in Arizona, so that's just what I'm used to.
I know sometimes people end up hating, like, the weather where they grew up. Not you, though.
I literally, like, I have no body fat, so I can't. I don't know, like, I don't know if that's why, but I just can't do the cold, dude. When it's too cold, I just, like, I can't do anything.
It makes sense. Do you have a favorite anime?
Death Note.
Favorite movies?
Okay, like, Lord of the Rings. Like, for sure. Lord of the Rings. Let's just say that. I'm not, like, a huge movie guy. Like, I like movies, you know, yeah. But I literally just can't think of any other movies right now.
I always have to ask this when it's not said, but have you ever seen Ferris Bueller's Day Off?
Yeah.
Do you like it or dislike it?
It's pretty good. I mean, wasn't that movie... It was, like, that's, like, in the 80s when that movie came out,
yes,
huh?
Yeah.
Yeah, it was pretty good.
Yeah, no, I really like it. I was afraid for a moment you were going to say it's horrible.
No, yeah. I like just, like... Just shut your brain off, like, comedy movies. Like, mm-hmm. I freaking love Will Ferrell. Like, anything Will Ferrell does, I love him. Anchorman. Like, Step Brothers is one of the best movies ever.
Oh, yeah, Step Brothers is fucking hilarious.
And freaking Talladega Nights, dude. Like, him and John C. Reilly, that's the power duo right there.
Yeah, has Will Ferrell done anything recently?
I don't know. I totally fell off with movies just because of the COVID and stuff. Yeah. But I gotta see what's going on.
So, I mean, this one might be harder, but favorite bands? I mean, I know, okay, you mentioned a few earlier, but, like, any others?
Dude, you know, I'm in, like, In Flames, freaking... Like, yeah, because you're talking about, like, bands that I've seen live, but it's just, like, you know, like, In Flames, Iron Maiden, you know, dude. We'll go with those two.
Okay.
Those are good.
Best shittiest game. Basically, it's a game that you like. Do you understand what I mean by that, or do you need me explain?
Yeah. Best shittiest game.
Mm-hmm.
Quest 64.
Hey, actually, yeah, you're the first person to say that. Now I think about it. Yeah, Quest 64 is interesting.
But I mean, like the actual like the music is amazing. The environments are really captivating. The story is like whatever. It's okay, but like. The actual, like, mechanics and, like, game design, the way the stats work, like, it's so bad. Like, it's so bad. You literally have to, like, play the game, like, a certain way or else it's, like, obnoxiously hard.
Have you seen a speedrun of it?
I've seen, like, a couple, but I don't know if it's, like, the one that... Why?
I was just curious.
Oh, okay, I thought you were gonna be, like... I thought you were going to say there's some, like, some silly trick or something in it. That game, I mean, it's one of those things that, like, when you're a kid, you're like, this is a cool game. And then you realize, you're like, oh, wait, that game sucked.
Yeah, I had that exact feeling, actually, because I played it as a kid. And then later I grew up and I was like, I went through a thing where I got a bunch of N64 games. And that was one of the ones I got. And I played it and I'm like, I don't remember it being like this.
Yeah, it's... Because in that game, it's, like, you have the four elements. You can do, like, fire, water, earth, air. And, like, mm-hmm. If you literally don't go water, you can't heal yourself. So, you're screwed. Like, so it's literally just, like, go water, you know? Or yeah. Else you're, you know.
Worst game everyone loves. Just something that people love that you just can't get. Well, you don't have to obviously say it's terrible. It's just something that you physically can't get into. I mean, kind of like Dark Souls, maybe, but, yeah.
Well, it's like that's hard because it would have to be a game that I actually like gave a fair shot, right? Because yeah. I didn't really give Dark Souls a fair shot, so I'm not gonna sit here and be like, you know, yeah. What's a game that I've like given like a really fair shot and didn't like? I don't really have an answer to that, because it's just like I truly like I feel like Dark Souls is like the closest one for me of that, but I don't want to I don't feel like it's fair for me to say that having not beaten it, you know.
Yeah, no, I understand.
But like I put like multiple tens of hours into it and I still haven't really. I feel like a game should you should enjoy it like when you start it, you know.
Yeah.
So like it kind of didn't have that effect on me, but you know, for all I know, maybe like the next level is like where I would start having fun, you know. So
okay, do you believe in the supernatural?
It depends. Like, are we talking about aliens or like ghosts?
Oh,
or,
this is like this is ghosts.
I'm definitely like it's like sure, you know. I'm very like agnostic if that applies to that, where I'm just like I believe that they could exist, but I haven't necessarily had an experience with ghosts.
Yeah,
or anything. I actually like really want to, you know how they have those like hotels that are like haunted and everyone's like they're like oh god, we gotta like are you tough enough to stay at this hotel? And I'm like, dude, I want to, like, I honestly want to like see, like, I want to experience that, you know.
Actually, a week, like about a week ago, my mother went to a prison or like a haunted prison or something, and I think West Virginia. So that's, yeah, I know what you're talking about. You're talking about hotels, but I'm, yeah, prisons. There's just a lot of stuff like that.
Yeah, I certainly, I definitely believe that humans, we don't know like anything, right? Like we don't, like we see in three dimensions. There's probably like 17 dimensions. You know, it's just like we're literally just like a bunch of little hamsters, you know what I mean? Like, we don't know what's going on. So there certainly could be some stuff going on that we don't know about, like that.
Bringing up what you said, but yeah, so is there life out there somewhere? You know, aliens. Just, it doesn't have to be googly-eyed aliens, just life in general.
Oh, on other planets? Yeah.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Yeah,
there's probably a whole freaking, there's probably a whole network of planets, like, you know, there's probably a whole trading system, you know. I think there's so much stuff going on, probably.
Yeah, the scarier thing to think of would be that there isn't. But yeah, no, it wouldn't make sense to me for us to just be like the one. We're the
dude,
one.
There's no way. I mean, it's like there's probably like so many situations in the universe where you have like, because the reason we have life on Earth is because we're the perfect distance from the sun.
Yep.
Where we're not burning to death and we're not freezing to death. Like, it's that perfect position. But that there's planets next to their own suns that are just like that, you know.
You could also argue that, you know, some things out there might not need, you know, the sun like we do. So,
oh yeah, or they enjoy, you know, living on a lava world or a ice world, you know.
Yeah.
There's definitely life on other planets for sure.
So if you could live anywhere in the world, where would you want to live?
I want to see more of the world, you know, like, but
yeah,
you know, there's definitely some places in Europe that look wonderful. And I feel like every place in the world has its own problems for sure.
Of course.
But, if we're just talking about like how it looks, right? Cause I don't know about politics. I don't know about whatever, you know, I can't predict what my experience there as an individual would be. But if we're just talking about like the way it looks, like, dude, I love seeing pictures of like Scandinavia, like Sweden, Finland, Norway. Like, that looks like such a beautiful place to live. Although I literally was just saying I don't like the cold, so that might be an issue. But yeah, Scandinavia looks beautiful. Also, like, New Zealand looks beautiful.
Was it Lord of the Rings stuff shot in New Zealand, or am I wrong?
Yeah, I believe so. So New Zealand looks sick. And also, it seems like New Zealand is just, like, they're like, nobody talks about New Zealand. And that's where I want to live. I want to live in a place where nobody talks about it. Like, I just want to, like, live my life and no one, you know what I mean? Like,
yeah.
Like, so that seems like a nice place, but I'm sure they have their nobody's no place is perfect, but that I think those two areas would be top contenders for me.
If you had a spirit animal, what would it be and why?
I don't know. I mean, like, I'm not like super astrology man, but like I kind of resonate with like because I was born in December, so my sign is like Capricorn. So like I think I've always kind of like felt like goat is like a it can that kind of sometimes I feel that way, you know what I mean? Like,
Yes.
so I'm just like, okay, that's we'll go with goat.
Weirdest and scariest dream you can remember.
I actually have this funny story. I think I've told this story before at some point, but when I was like a little kid, I had this weird I saw an orchestra. It was like this huge orchestra. And for some reason that night, I had this nightmare where like this like guy playing a trombone was like in my hallway, just like, and it was really creepy. Like, so for like a little while there, I was actually afraid of like trombones because I just like had this really creepy dream about this like guy playing a trombone.
So he was still
So
playing it in the hallway?
yeah, it was like imagine this like really ominous, like weird trombone sound,
Yeah, that would be
and
weird.
it was like and I couldn't like see him, but it was like a shadow on the wall of like this guy playing a trombone. It was really creepy.
Yeah.
So that was like kind of a weird dream that I had.
What was like the first meme you've seen online, and what's your favorite meme?
The first meme. That just reminds me of like old school internet where it was just like flash videos and stuff and like Newgrounds and like all that stuff.
Yeah, no, go on.
Like I'll give a shout out to like well, I don't are you talking about like image meme or like video meme?
Could be any, really.
Like one of my favorite a band that I like a lot, like Psycho Stick, they had that really famous that's how they blew up because of the beer video. And like that's such a classic old school 2007 internet video where it's like the beer song.
Yeah.
So like that's like one of the first like Newgrounds and like all the they just had so many banger videos, dude.
Yeah,
Like
I was.
freaking
Sorry, go ahead.
Psycho Stick and like all your bass are belong to us, like and just like so many old school videos like that,
Yeah, I used to be on Newgrounds all the time. I just lived on it, and then one day I stopped.
Yeah. Newgrounds was sick though back in the day. I mean, I'm sure it is now too. I just, but back in the day it was awesome too.
Yeah. So, what about favorite meme currently, if you even have one?
My favorite meme currently. TikTok is so freaking weird. Like, I don't know. There's so many weird freaking memes on TikTok, man. Like, I'm trying to think. I honestly don't know. There's just I'm overwhelmed with how many memes I see like on a daily basis. It's too much.
Yeah,
I can't have
oh, sorry.
I can't I just can't pick one.
Basically, TikTok's just meme overload.
Yeah, it literally.
Okay,
Like Seabat, dude. We'll go with Seabat.
so where would people go to follow you in general?
Twitter is good. Well like yeah, Twitter is like my name's ToxicxEternity on every social media that I'm on. So it's like Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, those ones. But then like the actual content ones, which is like Twitch and then YouTube. Those are the it's all ToxicxEternity.
Yeah, I'll make sure to link your stuff in the description. Normally, I would be like, oh, hey, would you consider collabing in the future again? Obviously, you and me, two completely different people because, music. I wish I got into music like I did back then. I could definitely say, thanks for taking the time out of your day to, be here and whatnot. I mean, it would be cool to talk to you again one day in the future, yes.
Yeah, absolutely, dude. And we'll
And
do a follow-up sometime.
hopefully, you've had a good time. Hopefully it wasn't too awkward or anything at any point.
Nah, dude. It just feels like we're hanging out, dude. So that's cool. I appreciate you. It definitely seems like you came up with some cool questions. So I appreciate that.
But anyways, hopefully people enjoy the interview. If you haven't already followed Jack, make sure to check the description for everything and whatnot. Listen to his newest covers, oldest covers, newest, because you prefer your newest, obviously, but your old stuff's still good.
Yeah, just listen to whatever your favorite game is. Just, you know, listen to that.
There's definitely going to be something on this channel for everybody, to be honest, so I would, you know, just look. Amy, your channel goes back, like, 15 years, I'm pretty sure.
Almost, yeah.
Well, yeah,
so my first video was, like, 2007, I think. You know, so it's a lot. It's a long time.
Yeah, but yeah, is there anything you want to say before I end the recording?
Just like to anybody listening, man, just thank you for the support and thank you for listening and, you know, just hit me up and let me know what you think about what I do. And, you know, I have a Discord server too, which anybody is welcome to join if you want to hang out. And yeah, just keep freaking jamming, you know, keep rocking out.
I hope everyone enjoyed the interview with ToxicxEternity, aka Jack. Make sure to check the description and the pinned comment for links to his socials, YouTube, you know, etc. There's also a paste bin that has a bunch of things, you know, linked that was mentioned throughout the video. Of course, definitely give a listen to their covers, old and new, because as you've heard, they've been around for a long time and they have improved constantly throughout their YouTube career. If you enjoyed the interview and want more, make sure to hit the subscribe button and hit the notification dingy bell because it actually works. And of course, like the video if you enjoyed it, dislike if you didn't. I have playlists for all of my videos that I've done, including the interviews. Not including this interview, there's also 7 others I've done. I interviewed Ultra J-Man, an old YouTuber slash indie game developer, iCran Girl, who's a YouTuber, Kane, the creator of I Wanna Be The Guy, Lord Athelstan, who is a Twitch streamer, Studio Anjin, which is an indie game dev studio. They're currently working on Nanokin. The 8-Bit Drummer, who's a Twitch streamer and a drummer, of course. And Jamonius, who's also an indie game developer. And of course, you just watched the ToxicxEternity interview, which, you know, metal guitarist who does video game covers, and etc. I have 2 more interviews, and I'll upload those as soon as I can. Of course, make sure to check out all my other stuff, because I have, like, tons of highlight videos, top 10 countdowns, and just other stuff in general. I hope everyone had a great day, and I'll see you guys in the next video.